In the first book of Adam and Eve, chapter 35, then God looked again upon Adam and his weeping and groaning. And the word of God came to him and said unto him, O Adam, when thou wast in my garden, thou knewest neither eating nor drinking, neither faintness nor suffering, neither leanness of flesh nor change, neither did sleep depart from thine eyes. But since thou transgressed and camest into this strange land, all these trials are come upon thee. Chapter 36. Then God commanded the cherub who kept the gate of the garden with the sword of fire in his hand to take some of the fruit of the fig tree and to give it to Adam. The cherub obeyed the command of the Lord God and went into the garden and brought two figs on two twigs, each fig hanging to its leaf. They were from two of the trees among which Adam and Eve hid themselves when God went to walk in the garden. And the word of God came to Adam and Eve and said unto them, Adam, Adam, where art thou? And Adam answered, O God, here am I. When I heard the sound of thee and thy voice, I hid myself because I am naked. Then the cherub took two figs and brought them to Adam and Eve, but he threw them to them from afar, for they might not come near the cherub by reason of their flesh that could not come near the fire. At first, angels trembled at the presence of Adam and were afraid of him. But now Adam trembled before the angels and was afraid of them. Then Adam drew near and took one fig, and Eve also came in turn and took the other. And as they took them in their hands, they looked at them and knew they were from the trees among which they had hidden themselves. Then Adam said to Eve, Seest thou not these figs and their leaves, with which we covered ourselves when we were stripped of our bright nature? But now we know not what misery and suffering may come upon us from eating them. Now therefore, O Eve, let us restrain ourselves and not eat of them, thou and I, and let us ask God to give us of the fruit of the tree of life. Thus did Adam and Eve restrain themselves and did not eat these figs. But Adam began to pray to God and to beseech him to give him the fruit of the tree of life, saying thus, O God, when we transgressed thy commandment at the sixth hour of Friday, we were stripped of the bright nature we had and did not continue in the garden after our transgression more than 3 hours. But on the evening thou madest us come out of it, O God, we transgressed against thee 1 hour, and all these trials and sorrows have come upon us until this day. And those days together with this, the 43rd day, do not redeem that 1 hour in which we transgressed. O God, look upon us with an eye of pity, and do not requite us according to our transgression of thy commandment in the presence of thee. O God, give us of the fruit of the tree of life, that we may eat of it and live, and turn not to see sufferings and other trouble in this earth, for thou art God. When we transgressed thy commandment, thou madest us come out of the garden, and didst send a cherub to keep the tree of life, lest we should eat thereof and live, and know nothing of faintness after we transgressed. But now, O Lord, behold, we have endured all these days and have borne sufferings. Make these 43 days an equivalent for the 1 hour in which we transgressed. After these things, the word of God came to Adam and said unto him, O Adam, as to the fruit of the tree of life for which thou askest, I will not give it thee now, but when the 5500 years are fulfilled, then will I give thee of the fruit of the tree of life, and thou shalt eat and live forever, thou and Eve and thy righteous seed. But these 43 days cannot make amends for the hour in which thou didst transgress my commandment. O Adam, I gave thee to eat of the fig tree in which thou didst hide thyself. Go and eat of it, thou and Eve. I will not deny thy request, neither will I disappoint thy hope. Therefore bear up unto the fulfillment of the covenant I made with thee. And God withdrew his word from Adam. So I wanted to point something out. Now that we read that little story, do you guys notice in this book, there's God, and then there's the Word of God? And do you notice that every time that Adam and Eve are talking to God, they're talking to the Word of God? Let's just look what it says here. Then God looked upon Adam and Eve, or Adam and his weeping and groaning, and the Word of God came to him and said unto him. So you guys know who the Word of God is? That's the Son of God. That's Jesus. So the way this book says it, God is on his throne and he's a spirit, but he sends his word. I mean, how many of the prophets say the word of the Lord came to me and told me to write this down or showed me a vision or whatever? Let's see here. Look what it says. I think it's the next chapter. Okay. After these things, the word of God came to Adam and said unto him, and then it says, and God withdrew his word from Adam. That's the Father and the Son. Anyway, I don't understand the 5,500 years. We'll keep reading a little bit, I guess. Then Adam returned to Eve and said to her, arise and take a fig for thyself, and I will take another, and let us go to our cave. Then Adam and Eve took each fig and went towards the cave, the time being about the setting of the sun, and their thoughts made them long to eat the fruit of the fruit. But Adam said to Eve, I'm afraid to eat of this fig. I know not what may come upon me from it. So Adam wept and stood praying before God, saying, satisfy my hunger without my having to eat this fig. For after I have eaten it, what will it profit me? And what shall I desire and ask of thee, O God, when it is gone? And he said again, I'm afraid to eat of it, for I know not what will befall me through it. Then the word of God came to Adam and said unto him, O Adam, why hadst thou not this dread, neither this fasting, nor this care ere this? I don't know what that's saying. And why hadst thou not this fear before thou didst transgress? But when thou camest to dwell in this strange land, thy animal body could not be on earth without earthly food to strengthen it and to restore its powers. And God withdrew his word from Adam. The first human thirst. Then Adam took the fig and laid it on the golden rods. Eve also took her fig and put it upon the incense. And the weight of each fig was that of a watermelon, for the fruit of the garden was much larger than the fruit of this land. But Adam and Eve remained standing and fasting the whole of that night until the morning dawned. When the sun rose, they were at their prayers, and Adam said to Eve, after they had done praying, O Eve, come, let us go to the border of the garden looking south, to the place whence the river flows, and it is parted into four heads. There we will pray to God and ask him to give us to drink of the water of life. For God has not fed us with the tree of life in order that we may not live. We will therefore ask him to give us of the water of life and to quench our thirst with it, rather than with a drink of water of this land. When Eve heard these words from Adam, she agreed, and they both arose and came to the southern border of the garden, upon the brink of the river of water at some little distance from the garden. And they stood and prayed before the Lord and asked him to look upon them this once to forgive them and to grant them their request. After this prayer from both of them, Adam began to pray with his voice before God and said, O Lord, when I was in the garden and saw the water that flowed from under the tree of life, my heart did not desire, neither did my body require to drink of it. Neither did I know thirst, for I was living and above that which I am now. So that in order to live, I did not require any food of life, neither did I drink of the water of life. But now, O God, I am dead. My flesh is parched with thirst. Give me of the water of life that I may drink of it and live. Of thy mercy, O God, save me from these plagues and trials and bring me into another land different from this, if thou wilt not let me dwell in thy garden. Then the word of God came the word of God to Adam and said unto him, O Adam, as to what thou sayest, bring me into a land where there is rest. It is not another land than this, but it is the kingdom of heaven where alone there is rest. But thou canst not make thy entrance into it at present, but only after thy judgment is past and fulfilled. Then will I make thee go up into the kingdom of heaven, thee and thy righteous seed, and I will give thee them the rest thou askest for at present. And if thou saidst, give me of the water of life that I may drink and live, it cannot be this day, but on the day that I shall descend into hell and break the gates of brass and bruise my piece in pieces the kingdom of iron, kingdoms of iron. Then will I in mercy save thy soul and the souls of the righteous to give them rest in my garden. And that shall be when the end of the world is come. And again, as regards the water of life thou seekest, it will not be granted thee this day, but on the day that I shall shed my blood upon thy head in the land of Golgotha. For my blood shall be the water of life unto thee at that time, and not to thee alone, but unto all those of thy seed who shall believe in me, that it be unto them for rest forever. The Lord said again unto Adam, O Adam, when thou was in my garden, these trials did not come to thee, but since thou did transgress my commandment, all these sufferings have come upon thee. Now also does thy flesh require food and drink. Drink then of the water that flows by thee on the face of the earth. Then God withdrew his word from Adam, and Adam and Eve worshipped the Lord and returned from the river of water to the cave. It was noonday, and when they drew near the cave, they saw a large fire by it. So you guys see that right there, just how this is saying this. This is a prediction of Jesus coming and dying on the cross. For my blood shall be the water of life unto thee. And he said, but on the day that I shall shed my blood upon thy head in the land of Golgotha, at the end of the world, Christ is coming.